Hello Guitar Heroes, welcome back to Clone Hero Lessons. For those of you who were wondering about streaming, I decided to try it out the other day. So just keep an eye out, I might be streaming sometimes, but it's kind of hard to do commentary while I'm playing, so it won't be as good as the videos. But today, this video is going to be about playing Jordan, and particularly we're going to be watching Acai play Jordan for the most part, because he has a pretty interesting method of doing it. But just to start off, I'm just going to show you. So that's the main riff, basically. For the first, like, I don't know, minute or so of the song, it's pretty easy, simple stuff. It's just that same pattern over and over again for the most part. But how it goes is 3, 1, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4. Yeah, something like that. Honestly, this isn't really the part that you'll have much trouble with, because then you run into this. Now, I've talked about this a lot before, but this section is all just about doing triplets. So you're kind of just going to want to go like 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4. 3, 4, 5. I mean, it's just general sweeping stuff that you gotta get used to. And yeah, most of this song is just one big guitar solo. Alright, now right here, it's kind of the same thing. It's kind of the same as that other one, but you're doing more descending triplets. You can pretty much hold a bass note for most of it. So, like, it starts off with yellow, you go blue, 5, 4, 3, 5, 4, 3, 5, 4, 2, 5, 4, 2, 5, 3, 2, 5, 3, 2, 4, 3, 2. But that is when it gets into the really hard part. So this is what the actual solo looks like. So this whole part is mostly just a lot of trills, and then it gets into the section with a bunch of, well, more trills with some triplets. Alright, I'm gonna go over all this, but this is just so you can see what it looks like. For anyone who's never seen or heard of this song, this was basically the Through the Fire and Flames of Guitar Hero 2. So Guitar Hero 2, it was a lot harder to play because, I mean, just the mechanics of it, the hitboxes were much smaller, and man, I remember the first day I passed this when I was like 13 and I just went nuts. But we're gonna watch Acai play it right now, so let's see. So he's playing it at 190% speed, which means I can slow it down to half speed to show what he's doing. But something I want to mention, he came up with this new method of playing Jordan, which I thought was really interesting. I haven't seen him explain it, but I paid attention and saw what he's doing. So here, let me just show you what I'm doing here. Okay. So you've got all the buttons right here, and so normally you, the way I taught how to do trills is to like hold one note and then like just tap the other one really fast, like you would like normal, or hold any others and then tap it like that, or do this, or stuff like that. But something that works specifically well for this song is to basically. So let's say you're trilling red and yellow. So what Acai usually does is he'll just kind of hold the green the whole song, and then he'll go 2-3-2, just sort of like barely tapping that to go 2-3-2, and then he'll use his two fingers on his other hand to go 3-2-3, and he'll just tap and then slide. So he's just alternating three notes. So we're just gonna. look at what he does for this song. So yeah, this is at 190% speed, as you can see on the screen. So we're just gonna skip ahead. Yeah, there's this other part of the riff too, but I mean this whole intro riff is something that you can pretty easily figure out. Alright, so right there you can see when you're playing this really fast, you kind of have to, like, you know, alternate your hands going up the sweeps. So that's something that I've mentioned quite a few times in other videos. Alright, now we're going to slow this way down. We're going to slow it down to... Alright, so right there you can see. Watch his fingers. So, like I was saying, so what you're... So from right here, he'll just be holding green. He's going to tap yellow, blue, yellow, just like that. And then he can just do orange, blue, orange. And then yellow, blue, yellow, and then blue, yellow, blue. So instead of going just like 3-4, 3-4, 3-4, 3-4, you know, using one hand doing one and the other hand doing the other, he's going 3-4-3, 4-3-4, 3-4-3, 4-3-4. So he's just swapping off three notes. So, so we're just gonna, so you can really just pay attention to his fingers, how he just swaps off. And yeah, as you can see right here, this is, like, these kind of trills are terrible when you're trying to, like, just hold one note and hit it, because you'd have to go hold yellow, hit blue, and then hit yellow, and then you'd have to hit blue, or then you have to hit orange, hold blue, hit orange, and then hold yellow, hit blue, hold yellow. And like that kind of method, when you're trying to bounce it back and forth, doesn't really work so well. So it's easier right here for him to just like go yellow, blue, yellow, and then orange, blue, orange. Because this still basically is a trill pattern. It's just that it's moving from these two to these two. So, yeah, it's kind of a weird pattern and a weird way to pull it off. So, yeah, that basically explains how to do these trills. And then, yeah, you can really see on his hands right here how he's always, like, swiping three notes and just kind of taking turns with his hands. So yeah, back to his trill method. And now this is something that you've probably seen before. He does this a lot. So this is basically like rake tapping. So this is a pattern where you can actually just hold one note and then, you know, go back. Now I usually just say tap it with these two fingers or something, but what he does is he goes like, he swipes it and goes 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And we'll see if I can get a better view of this. So yeah, when you're just holding one note, and you just gotta go 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So when you're doing it fast, you can, you're basically just wanting to fit as many notes in as much, in as little time as possible, basically. So, back to this. And then, yeah, mostly just shredding. But at this speed, he's gotta tap the whole thing. So yeah, there's not a whole lot to say about this part. It's kind of everything I've already been saying, like how you gotta just learn to, I would say at normal speed you don't really have to tap, like you can get by without it, but when you're trying to play at 190% speed, then yeah, it's pretty much mandatory. So we're just gonna go up to, it's kind of funny to think this is regular speed. Like, the video speed. And then, yeah, a bunch of quick strummings. Now, this is kind of a thing that shows up a lot, especially in this song. So, if you're unfamiliar with these, where there's like a hammer-on and then a strum and then a hammer-on and then a strum, they're actually pretty easy to get down. Now, you can just alternate strum, like going through. So yeah, you could just go orange, blue, yellow, red, but when it's fast and you don't want to waste too much effort, you can just tap orange and then strum orange, and then tap blue and then strum blue. And there's a lot of stuff like that, especially in this song, but also quite a few others. Yeah, he's one-handing most of that, and then just zigzags, sweeps. Now, here's another example. So these are basically sets of three notes, but you'll definitely want to hold the green, so then you'll go blue, and then let go, and then that'll tap the green, then you strum the green, and then yellow, green, strum. Orange, green, strum. So that's what it would sound like while you're trying to play it. Yeah, then it's just the outro. So yeah, there you have it. That's kind of a rough way to play Jordan, both at regular speed and also if you're trying to play it much faster. If you're just looking to pass it, then you're probably just in the realm of tapping and spamming as fast as you can. Like, this is a particularly hard song to tap just because of how much it moves the patterns all over the place. But if you can do well on this song, then you're doing well. Cause, yeah, back when Guitar Hero 2 was the big game, this was like, I mean, this song is like twice as hard as anything else on the whole set list. So, but that's all for this video. So thanks for watching.